Good evening and welcome to Christ Lutheran Church, Roanoke, Virginia. We invite you to join us for our evening prayer service this evening. The order for service is found on our website, ChristLutheranRoanoke.org. We invite you to join us for this service of evening prayer. We invite you again on Sunday to be with us on Facebook Live at 10 a.m. for our Sunday morning services. We will be having a drive-in service here every other Sunday, beginning not this Sunday, but the next, and every other Sunday through August. We invite you to be with us and to worship and to praise God Most High. And now let us take a few moments in silence as we prepare our hearts and minds for worship. God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Show us your mercy, O God, and grant us your salvation. Give us the joy of your saving help again, and sustain us with your bountiful spirit. Give peace in all the world, for only in you can we live in safety. Keep the nations under your care, and guide us in the way of justice and truth. Let your way be known upon earth, your saving health among all nations. Let not the needy be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and sustain me with your Holy Spirit. Lord, hear my cry, and let my cry become before you. Reading from 1 John, the 4th chapter, beginning with the 7th verse. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. God's love was revealed among us in this way. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. In this is love. Not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the atoning sacrifice for our sins. Beloved, since God loved us so much, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is perfected in us. By this, we know that we abide in him, and he in us, because he has given us his Spirit. And we have seen and do testify that the Father has sent his Son as the Savior of the world. God abides in those who confess that Jesus is the Son of God, and they abide in God. So we have known and believe the love that God has for us. God is love, and those who abide in love abide in God, and God abides in them. Love has been perfected among us in this, that we may have boldness on the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love. But perfect love casts out fear. For fear has to do with punishment. And whoever fears has not reached perfection in love. We love because he first loved us. God's love is sure. God's love is constant. God's love is perfect, and you are loved. The question for this week was, how do you live out your faith through your relationship with yourself on a daily basis as a child of God's love? Participated in sending in your questions. Please continue to share your insights and your thoughts with your friends. Thank you. Thank you. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Gracious Father, we pray for your church. Fill it with truth and peace. Where it is corrupt, purify it. Where it is in error, direct it. Where in anything that is amiss, reform it. Where it is right, strengthen it. Where it is in need, provide for it. Where it is divided, reunite it. Remember us, Lord. By your word, eternal God, your creation sprang forth, and we were given the breath of life. By your word, eternal God, death is overcome. Christ is raised from the tomb, and we are given new life in the power of your Spirit. May we boldly proclaim this good news in our words and our deeds, rejoicing always in your presence. Remember us, Lord.
Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
Gracious and holy God, lead us from death to life, from falsehood to truth. Lead us from despair to hope, from fear to trust. Lead us from hate to love, from war to peace. Let peace fill our hearts, our world, our universe. Remember us, Lord.
Jesus, remember me.
Watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep, and give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, give rest to the weary, strengthen those near and dear to us, bring healing to Nancy and all in need of your healing spirit. Console the family of Dan, of Don, and all who grieve. Bless the dying, soothe the suffering, comfort the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for your love's sake. Hear our prayers today, especially for those we name before you now, from our hearts to you. Remember us, Lord.
Jesus, remember me when
grant, O God, that your holy and life-giving Spirit may move every human heart, that the barriers dividing us may crumble, suspicions disappear, and hatred cease, and that with our divisions healed, we might live in justice and peace. Remember us, Lord.
Jesus, remember me when you
give thanks to you, Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have graciously protected us today. We ask you to forgive us all our sins, where we have done wrong, and graciously to protect us tonight. Into your hands, we commend ourselves, our bodies, our souls, and all that is ours. Let the holy angels be with us, so that the wicked foe may have no power over us. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Almighty God, bless us, defend us from all evil, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Go in peace.